Okay, I want to do a little video here and talk about, I guess, like Cooey single shots overall, and about the way that the bolt works and stuff. This sort of is for Gunner James. He had a video that's, I don't know, a few years ago or whatever it was. He was shooting a Model 82 Cooey, which was like the military trainer version, but it's basically the same action. It's just Etonia here. And these bolts, when you close them, they go to half cock, and then you have to pull the bolt back every time to shoot it. And but you know, it happens to everybody. People, you forget to pull it back, and you try to pull on the trigger, and usually you get nothing. But his one, it was jumping out of the half cock notch. So I mentioned that it was probably worn or something, but I think he knew what I was getting at. But I'm gonna do a little video and show the stuff. Anyone else is interested, or whoever else has this issue or whatever. But as you can see right now, there's no gap there. But you open the bolt and you close the bolt. See, there's this gap here. And that's the half cock notch. It keeps the theoretically, so you can carry the gun safely with a round in the chamber. Keeps the firing pin from just sitting on the, like if it was, if you carried it like this, basically the firing pin is sitting on the rim of the case, and if it gets hit here, it could go off. So anyway, so you close it like that, it goes to half cock, you pull the trigger, it shouldn't do anything, but when, on his one, you pull the trigger, it would lurch forward a little bit, but it wouldn't set the round off because it's not going far enough. And then you remember to pull the bolt back and fire it, because normally you go like this, and then you see something you want to shoot at, then you pull it back and like that. But all this is accomplished by these cuts in the bottom of the bolt here. So the sear will go along and it'll jump this little ramp here, and then this is your half cock notch here. It's like a little claw. It should be fairly well defined, so the, because the front part of the, or the back part of the sear, is a, you know, corresponding kind of claw that grabs into this, and it, you try to pull the trigger, it won't come out. Like when you close, when you pull the trigger and close the bolt, then the sear sits up this little ledge here, but otherwise it'd be right here. And then your full cock is here in between, but since this is ramped like this, it'll go and it'll jump that. It won't you know, I've seen some where people cut this away, so then it it'll go to full cock when you close it, but it's sort of dangerous. so there must be some wear here, or this is actually the end, like the tip of it's broken off, or somebody has filed on that, or something or other. This is the, you can't see it in there, but the sear is, so like a claw in the front and the back, it's sort of flat. It acts as a bolt stop, hits against this here. They're super simple, but they do wear, I guess, over time. I don't know what the steel was super hard in these or what, but you're talking about 22, you're not talking super high pressure, because the bolt handle is like silver soldered on and stuff like that, so they're not super tough or anything, but they're adequate, because there's a lot of old Cooeys around, they're still going, so they do last. I don't know what time period this would be, like 1950s or something. This is sort of like it's basically a Cooey Ace Type 2, because it has the adjustable back sight here instead of the fixed one here. And the stock's a tiny bit more well-defined. Like some of the earlier Aces, the stock was more board shaped, didn't have sort of I think they had no butt plates, some of them. So. No gripping grooves and stuff. But anyway, Tony was just the one that was sold by Eaton's. So they sold all kinds of stuff like that. So. But, anyway, I figured I'd do a little video and try to show how that works. But, anyway, talk to you later.